Let's have an image and let's check out the image. So let's take a simple image. Okay. Now, what exactly is rather the remove subplot, so we can analyze the image in a better fashion. So this is a normal image, okay, and we already know the basic concepts of the low pass filter, the high pass filter. Now, what exactly is noise with respect to any image? Okay, we have something called IM noise. Okay, IM noise function can add noise with the image. There are several types of noise. So say IM2 is equal to IM noise. Once you press F1, you'll see that noise can be given by introduce, by specifying the type of noise and its corresponding parameters. Okay. There are several different kind of noise. Okay, salt and pepper and speckle are the most common form of noise. Speckle noise is a multiplicative noise and salt and pepper is an additive noise. So let us work with salt and pepper and let us see how it works. Okay. This is the percentage of noise that you are adding, say 20% of the noise. Now, just like our other processing, most of the image processing techniques will be for grayscale images. Okay, so you need to apply all the images in three domains. RGB are the three domains. We already know that in order to extend any algorithm which is to be applicable on the grayscale images, all we need to do is simply take a for loop and extend it over the three color domains. Okay. So let us take, say, this image. This is, now when we talk about the noise, okay, this is what noise does to the image. Okay, so salt and pepper noise is going to change several pixel values, okay, based on the probability, and it is going to alter those pixel values. Okay, so once you make the image, once you add noise with the image, this noise acts like a high frequency because its occurrence will be after several pixels. Okay, so as you can see, after several pixels the noise will be appearing. Okay, and this is quite a heavy noise. We can actually say, if I add 5% of the noise, the image looks something like this. Okay. The image looks something like this, and it is clearly to be seen that the noise are repeated after many pixels. Okay, so noises are not continuous, therefore they can be considered as a high frequency element. Okay, so noise can be filtered using any low pass filter. We know averaging and median are low pass filtering. Okay, if you take certain neighborhood values and replace the center value with that neighborhood, it acts like a low pass filter. Okay, so one of the very common low pass filtering that we see is known as the median filter. Okay, again, median filter is applicable for two-dimensional images, IM3 is equal to, in order to apply median filter, okay, let me apply the median filter in the noisy image. Okay. In median filter, we need to specify the size, that is, how many neighborhood we want to take in order to take the median. So, the rule of the filter becomes something like this. Assume that these are few image pixels, or rather, consider that this is part of the image. Okay. Now, how any filtering works is, first you need to mark one pixel. That is, I want to filter this pixel here. Okay. So, in order to filter this pixel, you first need to define a neighborhood. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So, this becomes a 3 by 3 neighborhood. So, what we do here is, in order to modify the pixel or filter the pixel, we take all the neighborhood values. And we calculate the median. Neighborhood values are nothing but the, if we apply the algorithm in two-dimensional space, that is separately in R, G and B, what happens is this is a value between 0 to 255. This is a value between 0 to 255. This is a value between 0 to 255. So in the median filtering, we first take all the pixels from the neighborhood of this particular pixel. Okay. After taking that, we arrange them in the, we sort them in ascending order, and then take the central value, that is the median, and we replace this value with the median. Now what we do is, next, once this pixel is filtered, next we go to next pixel, okay? Once we go to next pixel, again the neighborhood is selected from its neighbor. Then again, we go to next neighbor, affect the next pixel. Next we go to next neighbor, then affect this pixel. So in this way, this entire image is filtered. Okay. So we need to define for median filter how much neighborhood you want. Say, I want to take 3 images from rows and 3 images from the columns. And so, when you look at this, okay, this was the image which was noise affected. By taking the median filter, we can get rid of the noise, okay? That is because this is one of the methods of low-pass filtering. Now, let us increase the amount of noise. Let us keep increasing the amount of noise. So, once you keep increasing the amount of noise, you will see that some bits are not yet been filtered. Okay. Now, once you keep increasing the noise, say let me make it 50%, that is 50% of the pixels have been affected by noise. So, when 50% of the pixels have been affected by noise, as you can see, this is degraded image. Median filter can remove the degradation to a great deal, but it does not, it is never able to eliminate the entire degradation. Okay. So we'll stick to low amount of noise first, such that we'll be able to analyze the effect of noise and various filters. Okay. Now, another type of noise that we have is called speckle noise, okay, which is a multiplicative noise. Now, let us also analyze what is the role of a very simplistic got to see this bit carefully. This is a multiplicative noise. Okay? Look how the pixels are affected. Okay. This is not actually low frequency. Okay? The speckle noise, because it is multiplicative, it is quite high frequency. I mean, it's almost like it mixes up with the signal. So therefore, once you do median filtering, lot of noise stresses are still left out. Okay. This is left out. However, the same amount of the same amount of salt and pepper noise can be easily removed by this simple filter. Now, we have one more filter which is known as kernel burst method. Okay. So, in the case of median filter, what we do is we select a neighborhood, and this window we move around all the pixels, and then we keep on affecting the center pixel of it. Okay, in this way we come to the end. Okay, so we start from the top, we keep on moving to next row, next row, next row. In this way we move the entire pixel. Okay, now in a kernel based method, what happens is you select the window, all right, but each in the median filter we just select the pixel as it is. In a kernel based method, each pixel is given a weight, say 1.5, minus 0.5, minus 3.5, minus 4.5. These weights are given based on the distribution. So if it is a Gaussian distribution, weight will start with low value and it will come to high, and then again it will go to low value. Similarly, if it is a Laplacian distribution, it will be something like this. Okay, so there are different distributions. So using these distributions we can actually filter it. So using in order to do a kernel based filtering, we need to first define the kernel. Okay, so the MATLAB command for defining an image kernel is F special. Okay, press F1, we'll see several kind of filtering: average filter, disk filter, Gaussian filter, Laplacian filter, logarithm filter, etc. One of the major cases is Gaussian filter, which is a blurring method. So any low pass filtering by default is a blurring process. Okay, so Gaussian filter will be given by 8 size, that is the kernel size, and sigma. Sigma is nothing but the variance. Okay, generally it will be around start from 0.5. So let us declare a Gaussian filter with size say 5 by 5, okay, in the neighborhood, and let us say variance equal to 0.5. In order to apply kernel based filter to the image, we write imfilter command. Okay, here I intend to filter the image with the kernel. Okay, so we'll first define a kernel, and then we'll take imfilter, we'll move this filter across the image and filter the image. Let us see the effect. This is also called blurring process. So this was the median filter result, okay, which of course give better result for salt and pepper noise, and this is the Gaussian blurry. Okay. Now, what if I increase the depth of the kernel, okay, if I increase the value say around 5.5, okay, what changes it? As you can see, by increasing the sigma, we should be able to filter the image even by Gaussian image. So filtering process is basically a blurring process. Few traces will be left out, but because of the blurring, the image effect will be reduced several amount of time. Now, what if you increase the size of the neighborhood? Now there are two ways how the filtering depth can be increased. So once you increase the size of the neighborhood, your image will start getting more blur, but the effect of noise will also start reducing. Okay. How about the case of speckle noise? Back to speckle noise. Observe very carefully here. In the case of speckle noise, because this is multiplicative filter, median value will not be able to filter it, because whichever pixel you want to take the median, all its neighborhood is also affected by noisy pixel. So if you want to replace a certain pixel, say for instance if you want to replace this pixel, okay, by this neighborhood values, these are all noisy values, because of which median filter cannot produce proper result in the case of such kind of multiplicative noise. However, when you look inside the Gaussian filter, because this blurring does not take into effect of the noise pixel, you get much more better output in the case of Gaussian filter. Let us again try reducing the number of neighborhood, that is the blurring process, and observe what exactly happens here. So now, when you compare a section, with respect to Gaussian, you'll see the Gaussian blurring results much better than median filter in the case of multiplicative noises. Just like median, there is one more blurring process, and that is the averaging. Okay, if we take the pixels from the neighborhood and if we take its average and put it at the center, okay, then that is also a low pass filtering. So just instead of Gaussian, let us look back to in the case of averaging, we do not need to define the sigma, we just need to define the neighborhood values. Okay. So how this averaging noise, averaging filter works? I should rather write. Okay, so now in this case you can see the blurring process will be almost producing the similar, the averaging process will be producing result similar to the Gaussian blurring. Okay, now there is one more process, which is the sharpening. Okay, the sharpening process is one where we enhance the edges of the images. Okay, so if you look at the original image, the edges may not be prominent, but using sharpening, the sharpening operation can make the edges prominent. All the pixel values around the edges will be much more different from the edges, and this is known as an unsharp mask. So let us declare one more operation called ipspecial.